service of better with you.
Okay, good. Thank you to Nathan for bringing that for me. Actually, I forgot it in my home. So before I start, I want all of you, I mean all of you, to forget everything you know. I mean like everything. Except for reading, of course. I don't want you to die. So, respected committee members of Malaysia Student Association, fellow speakers, fellow engineers, okay, maybe future engineers, no, nobody wants to be a future engineer, no. Okay, friends, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a very good morning, Abid, to all of you. So, how are you today? Well, not me. I cough a lot today. Actually, I have a bad fever this week. So I was like thinking, why did I want to join this program? I've been thinking for a while now, and now I'm having a bad cough. I don't think I can speak a lot. But today, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to share with you something new. No, I'm not going to make you learn new stuff. Actually, it's the opposite of that. I want you to stop learning and start thinking. So, did you need what I do? Did you forget everything? I mean everything?
Yeah.
You sure? If you have trouble, just think of this as an exam, because you know, we forgot everything during exam. So, ladies and gentlemen, what is the system that I'm talking about here? Are we going to be rebellious? Is this the time for us to act? No, if you do that, you'll be sent to Malaysia right now. So don't. Not going to do that. But let me show you something. This is a circle, right? This is a circle. Okay? It's not a circle. So, Gompa, is this a circuit?
Yes.
Okay, good. Come on, is this a circuit? Ade, is this a circuit? I don't remember. Your name is Ajay. Is this a circuit? Yes, it's a circuit. How about I ask someone like Ajay? Is this a circuit? It's an oval. Great. Say, is this a circuit? Oval. A whisker. Is this a circuit? It's like a circuit to you. Good. It's like sun. Is this a circuit? From your point of view. Okay, good. Good answer. It is a circuit. Okay, I need someone a bit creative here. How about chef? Is this a circuit to you? You guess so. How's that? Is this a circuit? This is hard. Come on! Hi! Exactly. So is this a circle?
Yeah.
You just see a circle here?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now, this is the system that I'm talking about. I'm telling you that this is a circle. So subconsciously, you are following my system. You are following the small system that I created, which is telling you this is a circle. Some of them actually broke a bit and it tells us that it's an oval. But if you see some autistic kids, they will tell them, oh, I see the world. I see some cookies. I see clothes. I see pizza. So, do you get a bit what I mean when I say breaking out the system? Yeah, just a bit of it. Now, let us try to go a bit further. What do we know about circle except for its shape? It's either square or it's round. Beside that, probably nothing. Roger Arthur Johnson, he did something with circles. Yes, he did not funny things, but things with circles. And he did this. He's actually a mathematician, and what he did is that he drew three circles which overlap each other and create an intersection. And by doing this, he created a new system, in math. Now, I'm not going to explain about this because if I explain it, the number would probably reduce to half. I can see someone yawning over there. It's covering your mouth. So, the point is, ladies and gentlemen, Johnson, this is called Johnson's second frame of revision. What he did was, he looked at the circle in his own perspective, while others see the circle just as a shape. He looked at it as something that he can use in math. He created a new system. So that's the system what I'm talking about. The norms. What the societies have been telling you and what you have been following since your birth. Go to school, ace your exams, study hard, then go to your college and study some more, and go to university and study some more, go for your master and study some more, blah blah blah, get a good job, get a good family. How many times in our life have we hearing this over and over and over again? Makes you want to say certain words, right? Hearing this make you want to well, you know what I mean, you're feeling that too. Now you have to remind yourself that do what you want to do, not what you are told to do. Now this is the first step by breaking out the system. Now the next thing that you have to do is to free your mind. Okay? Let your mind go wild. Not too wild. Not too wild. Okay? So for example here, we are, okay, let us be a bit imaginative. Okay? Because I really want you to be imaginative, creative, and innovative in this part after you break out from the system. Let's say, for example, you are a criminal. Yes, we are a criminal right now because we break out the system. So we break out the phone cell, for example. So if you are a criminal and you are breaking out from your cell right now, are you going to stay around? I mean, maybe, you know, go to with lemon at the side, relax, have a sip. Are you going to do that? No, you will want to run away, right? So what is the best mode of transportation so that you can go far away so that people cannot catch you? Anyone have an answer? Airplane. Good. Airplane. Now everyone have a piece of paper, right? So I will count down from 10 and you have to make an airplane, a paper plane that you can see go further than anyone else. Now 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, done. Is it too fast? It's not even 10 seconds. I'm breaking out the system, remember? I'm not going to come to 10. So, everyone, pull out the paper plane. Okay. Aha! Yes, I can see a lot of this. So, who's confident that his or her plan can actually go further than others? Good, can I see? Oh, okay. That is one good example. Look at that. Can you see his plan? It's actually quite the same with mine. So, we probably is breaking out the system now. So, good. So the thing about plane is that, what? This is not plane? This is not plane? Okay, the thing about plane is that they have wings, they have the airfoil, fuselage, engine, everything. Now, forget about that, okay? Forget about that. The point here is that I want you to make something. I want you to make something that is different, but functional with its objective. Does this count as does this count that I actually reached my objective? I just want you to make a paper plane that could fly far. I didn't ask you to make a plane that could carry 1,000 people and fly with them. Okay? So that's the point here, ladies and gentlemen. I want you to be more imaginative. Go far. Okay? Go far for others. Okay? Be innovative. That's the thing that I want you to do. So, do you know this basket?
Yeah.
Where is this?
China.
Yes, it's in China. Who in the right mind would tell someone, okay, I'm going to create a bus that can avoid traffic? What? A flying bus? But who would have thought that China can actually build a bus like this? It actually pass through cars and avoid the traffic. How amazing is that? How can someone think like this? There's this professor from Management Science University, and he was giving a speech, a lecture about creativity. And he was in this kind of discussion, and his friend told him, I want you to think outside the box. And he was like, what? But I'm already outside the box. Everyone is. The only thing left is that you use the potential in your mind to think creatively. And the problem is that it's not that we are in the box. We are the one who actually create the box around us. We limit our mind. That's a big problem here. Creativity is not like you make a pen or a chair or paper that people never seen before. But what you have to do is create a pen, a chair, or even a piece of paper in your own perspective. That's the point here. Okay? You get what I mean? Okay, next. So, we already break out from the system. We flew away from the system. So, what's next? Ladies and gentlemen. It's time for the final step. Now, okay, we are flying right now, right? We are flying away from the system. Okay, so I want you to be a bit creative here. So, we are flying right now, above high above the sky. What can you see? What can you see? Anyone? You see nothing? No? No spot. No one? Do you have anything in your mind? What do you see when you are flying above the sky, for example? Okay. I didn't hear that, but okay. Okay, go on.
Can you feel?
Feel. Good. Okay, seeing is a good thing, but it's not enough. What does anyone know Sherlock Holmes? So, what does he always say to his companion, Watson? Okay, he said this. You always see. You do not observe. Now, this is the last thing that we have to do. Because we are already away from the system, right? Now, we need to observe properly the system. Okay? We need to properly observe the system. Now, let me give you something, a riddle. So, the cartoon character in the bottom below represents a delivery man who is suspected of theft. Actually, he stole something from a company. He just visited the security staff and the police didn't find anything on him or in the delivery van. What has he stolen? Now, I give you simple tips there. Imagine you are the delivery man. I will give you another 10. 10, 9, 8, come on, let me answer. 7,
yes?
Good. The answer is the van itself. Was I wrong? No, right? So, if you observe properly, then from this simple picture, you can actually conclude that he's a real thief who stole the whole event. Interesting. Now, why do I want you to be imagine yourself as the delivery man? So, in the book itself, in the novel, Sir Conan Atherton, he wrote that observing is not just by our sights, but with all our sense, to feel, to taste, to hear, everything by. Let me give you another example so you can look a bit clearer on this case. So, now there's two guys who is furthering their degree and they are walking in a straight path. Now, the first guy, he just went through the straight path and got his degree by just studying his book. Okay? Now, the second guy, he was also walking in a straight path for his degree, but instead, while he was walking, he looked up and see the stars. And he crawled down and feel the earth. And he looked around and he was with the nature. Between the first and second guy, who do you think will understand more of what he is studying when he graduated? Do I need to repeat again? So there are two guys. Yes, of course, the latter, right? The second guy. So basically, what's important about observing is that it will help you to understand. To understand what? To understand the system that we are going to break up on. Because ladies and gentlemen, okay, do what I say to you. Now, why do I want you to understand the system? What is the relation between my speech and the theme for today? So, before I tell you about that, the thing about system is that it's not that you can really break away from it. It's not that you can really run away from it. You need a system. You need a system. But a system that you created in your own way, in your own perspective, that you have chosen. And there are really good examples out there. For example, like Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton, he didn't get to further his studies. He stopped learning. But he started thinking and he created algebra, calculus, and even founded gravity just by looking at an apple. Okay, feeling an apple on his hand. Now, we have, during that time, I don't know when, but when the time when other people were afraid to sail the sea, Galileo, he observed the world as a sphere. Now, we have people right now like Mark Zuckerberg, Steve Jobs, and Bill Gates. They dropped out from the college and created a multi-billionaire company. Amazing, right? Now, the thing about Steve Jobs is that he's very amazing. He created a good system for himself and also for his company. Well, until the new iPhone was released. Now, what I want you to do right now is that you have to try to create a system where you can see yourself 10 years, 20 years, or probably 50 years in the future. And you are not just going to bring yourself there. You are going to bring your country with you. The thing is, ladies and gentlemen, our country is in a standstill. We are not developing. We are not developing. It's a big problem. What is a vision 2020 plus 10 years, 20 years? How many years should we add more? It's going to be nothing if we are going to follow the same system again and again. Okay? How long that we have to depend solely on Petronas to stand in the global stage? So that's why I'm telling you right now. that we have a lot of professional, but what we want is innovators, us, to move our country further ahead. And not just an innovators, but innovators who will take to break out from the system. Thank you.